Hi there, gorgeous! Hope you're having a fabulous Monday and that your week is off to a great start. It is always a pleasure to see you, and thank you so much for taking the time to be here with me. In today's video, I'm sharing my top 7 favorite sunscreens for the face. This is one of the most requested topics as of late that I get asked a lot about, and so I wanted to do a whole video on my top favorite sunscreens. And it's a little bit different for your face as opposed to your body when it comes to sunscreens. The ones I'm showing you today also play extremely well underneath makeup. A lot of them do not have a white cast to them, so it's really great, especially for flash photography. So if you're looking for a new one to try, I have 7 excellent options here for you today. Before I get into the sunscreens though, I did have some factual information that I learned about face sunscreen that I wanted to share with you that comes directly from dermatologists, and it really opened up my eyes to what to look for in a sunscreen for the face, because it's a little bit different than what you might get for a sunscreen for your body. So the first thing is make sure it's broad spectrum, meaning that it covers UVA and UVB rays. It protects you from those rays. And when you're out in the sun, you will need to reapply a facial sunscreen every 2 hours or so. So keep that in mind. The SPF number does matter. Dermatologists typically will recommend that you go with an SPF of 50 or higher. I had always heard you should go with 30 and that should be your baseline, but they are saying 50, so. Yeah, and then it depends on how much you apply too. You have to apply the right amount, and they say that 1/2 teaspoon is what you will need for your face and your neck. If you're not applying at least 1/2 teaspoon, then you're not getting the coverage that the sunscreen advertises. The more you know. First sunscreen I have to share with you is from the brand Super Goop. And I tried this initially as a sample. I ended up falling in love with it. I went ahead and bought the full size, and it's usually one that I love to wear underneath makeup because it's undetectable. Not only does it not have any color, it does not have a scent, and it acts as a makeup primer that is perfect for all skin tones. This is the only sunscreen out of all 7 that I'm showing you here today that has the lowest SPF number of 40, so it's not as high as some of the others that I'm going to be showing you. If I'm going to be outside all day long, that is not my preferred go-to sunscreen. It's usually one that I wear when I know that I'm going to be indoors all day long, because I mean, you can still get damage through windows and things like that. So, I mean, I still wear it regardless, but anyway, wanted to put that out there. Another one that I highly recommend that I love is from Elta, and this is the MD skincare line. This is their UV sheer broad spectrum SPF 50, and it will protect you from the UVA and UVB rays. It is advertised as not having a white cast, but I don't find that with this formula. But what I do like about it is that it has a hydrating formula of hyaluronic acid and squalene, and that does help to keep moisture in the skin, and you can feel that when you apply it. And it is a top dermatologist favorite for so many reasons, but it's a really excellent sunscreen if you are going to be outside for an extended period of time. Aveeno. Aveeno makes a really excellent sunscreen, and this is their Protect and Hydrate Broad Spectrum SPF 70. So this is the highest protection number out of all the ones I'm sharing with you here today. It is sweat and water resistant for 80 minutes. This is really good if you suffer with eczema, psoriasis, if you have a more sensitive skin type that tends to flare up and experience allergic reactions more often, this would be an excellent one for you to try. I know I have to be really careful with my daughter's skin when it comes to sunscreens and things like that, so this one has started to work really well for her and we don't have any issues. The baby bum hasn't really given her any issues either, but this one is fantastic. Now, it does have a little bit of a white cast to it, so again, it's one that I will typically wear all by itself. If I wear it myself, obviously my daughter's not worried about that because she's almost 3 years old. So, but yes, just making you aware. There is a slight scent of sunscreen with the Aveeno one, but for the most part, it's very light. It doesn't smell as intense as, say, I think Copper Tone is one that has a really strong sunscreen smell. It's not anywhere near that strong. And most of the sunscreens that I'm sharing with you in today's video do not have a scent. If they do, I will let you know. This is probably the most scented one you'll find out of all of them. Another one of my favorites that I use quite often on my kids and started using it on myself because it's a great one is from Baby Bum. You can find this brand at Target, and this is their Mineral 50 Broad Spectrum SPF Water Resistant for 80 Minutes sunscreen. This one is vegan. It's also gluten-free. It is a mineral-based zinc oxide. It contains coconut oil, shea butter, and coconut butter, so it feels really nice on the skin. It does not leave an oily residue behind and absorbs pretty quickly. It does have a white cast, unfortunately, though. So again, it's another one that I tend to wear all by itself when I'm outdoors doing things like that. So wanted to make you aware. Now the next few sunscreens I have to share with you do not have any white cast whatsoever to them, and they are amazing. So the first one I wanted to share with you that fits that bill is from a brand called Black Girl Sunscreen, and this is their Make It Matte 45 Broad Spectrum sunscreen that is water resistant for 80 minutes. This is another brand that you can find in Target stores if you're not familiar with where to get it. It's readily available there. What I love about this is that there is no white cast to it, and it's especially great for my friends here who have darker skin tones. If you're looking for something that will not give you an ashy tint on your skin, this is excellent stuff, and it is perfect for dark skin tones also. It also has moisturizing ingredients like aloe, squalene, shea butter, and coconut oil, and it feels absolutely lovely on the skin. It's very velvety. It almost feels like a makeup primer. If you want to know what it feels like, that's what it feels like. And it works extremely well underneath makeup too. So excellent choice there. Another one I have to share with you is from the brand Peter Thomas Roth. And this is the Max Mineral Naked Broad Spectrum SPF 45. This does have UVA, UVB protection. And this one has a tint to it, which is what you'll see here in the up-close application. They say that it's universal, that it's supposed to fit every skin tone imaginable. I'm not sure if that's true. I haven't tested it. On me, it looks okay. I don't see any issues with it. And it is one that I like to wear on days when I'm wearing something all by itself because it gives me a little bit of coverage. I mean, it's not like a BB cream per se. It's like a sheer coverage foundation, very sheer, but it does a nice job of minimizing those minor imperfections in the skin. Now this one dries quickly. There is no sticky residue associated with it whatsoever. And it's also a great choice if you have acne prone skin and you're worried about sunscreen clogging your pores and that type of thing. So if that describes you, this would be a great one for you to try. Another one that I wanted to share with you is from, it's the last one. Sorry, I thought that I had another one, but this video went by very quickly. This is from the brand Biore, and it's their UV Aqua Rich Watery Essence. And this contains an SPF of 50 in it. It is a Japanese sunscreen. There is no chalky finish with this one whatsoever. It instantly dries down, and it has a very lightweight gel formula to it. And this is an excellent one for wearing underneath makeup all by itself. Whatever the case may be, I've really enjoyed this one. If you're wondering where you can find it, I was able to locate it on Amazon, and it's another great one to try. And when it comes to application, I typically apply my facial sunscreen not only on my face, but also on my neck, my chest, and the backs of my hands, because those areas are the ones where you will see aging first, and the true telltale signs of your age is not necessarily your face. It's usually your neck and the back of your hands. So it's really important not to skip those when you are applying your sunscreen. If you are interested in any of the sunscreens I shared with you here today, I will have all of them listed and linked for you below in the description box. And if you have a favorite I did not mention, please feel free to share that below as well. Thank you for being here, for taking the time to watch. I want to wish you a beautifully blessed week ahead, and I look forward to seeing you again next time. Psst, hi. Before I leave you, I always get asked about my eyes, so I wanted to share with you what is on my eyes in greater detail because it's going to be a little hard to describe this in the description box. So if you're interested, I used the Viseart palette today, and this is the violet one that they came out with. So on my lid, you will see I am wearing this shade and this shade mixed together, and then I took this shade and applied it into the crease, and then I used this to line my eyes. So if you're interested in this purple eyeshadow look, it is absolutely gorgeous. That is how you get it. Okay.